I'm going to be leaving in about 20 minutes. Got everything packed. And I suggest you do the same. Look on those videos that I took in my bathroom, particularly the one on the toilet is where I noticed it. When I was uploading it, I was trying to take 17 seconds off the front of a video, and it fast forwards and rewinds through the video until you hit the spot where you want to, well, you can edit it a little bit while you're uploading it from your phone. And in fast forwarding and rewinding, I see all these black dots flickering all over the place. You can do it too. Take a screenshot anywhere. If I don't know if it does it fast forward and rewind while it's on YouTube yet, but you take any one of those screenshots from anywhere on that toilet and then take another one, another one, another one, hold them side by side, and all those dots are moving around. Those are probably the thing that I have right here, two of, that look like little seahorses. In the picture where I contrasted right here, that are probably what they call thetans. That the, what's Tom Cruise and all them part of? Scientology. Tom Cruise and all the other stars, I don't want to think of their names right now, but you know what I'm talking about. Scientology, they say they're going to create an electrical device to clear your thetans. Like those little two horse, seahorse thingies that are sitting right here by me. Either that, or those are the eyes. Because that's what all those dots turn into when you're looking at the pattern that it emits around them. Just like those black dots that were floating up in the sky that created the pattern that's in the sky right now. As above, so below. There are big ones in the sky and small ones right there on my toilet. Those are the eyes, and everything you've done in this whole life has been seen. And you made it. Having said that, I've probably ran a risk hanging out here too long, but I'm going to upload this while I still have good upload speed on the Wi-Fi, and then I'll probably stop by a Starbucks here and there to upload, get a quicker upload speed, but I'll be transmitting and recording as I see fit, or am shown, or am prompted to. And if you understand everything in the nature of what I've shown you, you'll understand that they're programmed against you, and when the shields drop, you saw the end of the movie They Live, they freak. And it's going to be on you, because they see that you're in the body of Christ, and if they don't, their transmitter controllers do. Just like I said, they receive impulse, inspiration, inspired, but they don't, they're oblivious to it. So they don't know why they decided to take a right here instead of a left, stop for a coffee here instead of down the road, or vice versa. It's just an impulse they follow obliviously. And the people who are behind those impulses, and they're people, just like the people I'm going to go see, that I'd like to see you there too. There's other people that are pretty much just men. Men who've been playing God and are about to get taken. There was a truth behind that where he said there's three different kinds of people, and those two chromosomes make all the difference. The hive mind of the aboriginals and the some tribes in Africa, everyone else who's the inner rim, and the third level, and those who are of the hive mind are trying to keep all the inner rim from getting to the next level. And that's why they're programmed to keep you from getting there. This is a cosmic, interdimensional, biological race, and what better way to kill off the children of your enemy, or as every organic being and species in our world has, a competition for space to thrive. Are you a slave or a prisoner? That was the meaning of Mason Weaver's book when he said, the rope. What will you do with the rope? It's a mindset. A prisoner wants out. And when they're throwing a rope and showing a way out, they'll take it. A slave will run and tell master, hey, master, hey, someone throwing a rope over and trying to get people out of here. The other prisoners are trained to go fill the bricks in. When you start busting out a little spot to get out of the prison, they're trained to fill it back in and make an example out of you to the other prisoners. Not to mention, when they see what they see, they're going to freak. Okay? So if you've seen what I'm showing you, up until this point, I said, F what you heard, believe what you see. I'm going to show you some more stuff that just keeps occurring to me. I bought a newspaper today. And if you speak symbolism and you see the imagery, you might want to grab a copy of that paper too. I'm going to show you a little later. At least keep a copy of it on your phone. And I'll explain anything else that occurs to me along the way, but I just wanted to give you that opportunity to take screenshots of what I filmed in my bathroom, whether it's up here on the wall or down there on the toilet. You take screenshots, you'll see little black dots all over. That's not just dirt in my bathroom, though it is very dirty. Those little black dots are the eyes. Each one of those is what forms the eye to one of those images. That's why I say you can see a head going this way and a tail going that way, and they're all connected. Each one of those eyes forms an image. That was a cymatics image, a print, a signature on our reality. Jesus said he's going to slay everyone who doesn't worship him when he gets here. Didn't he? Fall in love again and meet me there. I'm going to head out.